Stealth Bife.
Hi guys, my name is Bife here from RF, and welcome back to Loot Drop. Sorry about that. Anyway, this episode we are going to be covering a sniper rifle. We're going to be looking at the Y-09 Longbow Synthesis. This is one of the new weapons that you get from the dock below. This is part of the Crucible set, and this weapon, I'd say, is... it's got some strong points to it. But it's really a nice all-purpose sniper rifle for you guys to use, and it comes in a whole variety of different flavors. But anyway, let's go ahead and very briefly look at what all of this nonsense is around here. We're in old Russia, and if ever I need to make a point about the weapon, I'm going to be using some cannon fodder. You can see I've already taken the opportunity to show these guys who's boss. So yeah, I will go ahead and extract information and valuable testing from these fallen down here. But in the meantime, let's take a look at what we'll be testing about. So, longbow synthesis. I'm going to go ahead and say it. Sniper rifles can be a bit of a mixed bag, and I speak from this as the perspective of a PvP player, as a lot of you guys know, and for me, a lot of it is down to how the sniper rifle feels and speed. So that's the big divide with sniper rifles. If the sniper has a really high rate of fire but low impact and a very high stability, it's really good for PvP. The perfect example of this is something like Praedus Time... Timepiece? Praedus Revenge, for saying that Praedus Revenge was Praedus Timepiece. Yeah, it's Praedus Revenge, because you have this really low impact, but a really, really high rate of fire, and very high stability, maxed stability. Not to mention, you've got great reload perks, this wonderful perk here, Firefly, where you can get explosions, and the maximized ammo of 6 rounds in every magazine. And just to give you an idea of how quickly this thing fires... to make some fallen run for cover... that's fast, and that's really fast, and each of the rounds in this is low caliber, and they do not do a lot of damage, and the punch is not great. But if you go ahead and compare our wonderful longbow synthesis to Praedus Timepiece, you can immediately see, bam, huge increase in impact. The rate of fire does, however, suffer a lot. So, yeah, it's probably more convenient if I do this. There we go. So the thing that this really does miss out on is a lot of stability, but that can be sort of fixed by a few different things, and this means that it's a much better multi-role sniper. You could definitely go ahead and still use this in something like PvP, but in PvE you want something which is much closer to Black Hammer, or something that's much closer to, say, Icebreaker, where you've got really heavy rounds that do a lot of damage. So yeah, let's pop a special synthesis here, Shock Horror. And let's go ahead and take a look at some of the other features. Now, the big thing, as you can see, is the low ammo capacity of this weapon. It only has 5 rounds in every chamber, which is good. That's just one below the maximum, but the real thing that's going to hurt you is the ammunition economy, because unlike something like Praedus Revenge, which has 24 rounds in total, this only has 12. And it hurts a lot, because the rounds, you have to really make them count, and this really does therefore punish people with poor accuracy a lot more. So, on that note, let's see what you'll be accurate with. Scopes. Eagle Eye, I think, is pretty good. As far as standardized scopes go, this is a nice starting option. I love the fact that you can go ahead and use this at a lot of different ranges, but I just dislike this scope generally from a PvP standpoint. PvE, this is amazing. Nice clear view on target, the ammunition counter's right there, and you know, if you are in a closer quarters environment, the larger thing of the crosshead does somewhat help. But honestly, I despise this thing in PvP. It feels a little bit too sort of heavy, the handling is not great, and I feel like there are better scopes out there. Second up, the long view. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this baby should be Longview SLR-10. There, it's on Praedus Timepiece. Revenge, again. And this scope, again, it's nice. It's a nice mix between the two, and it's a lot snappier. And the reason that I love scopes like this is because it does provide this nice, sort of clean, crisp view on target. And it's not too complicated. The problem with every single one of these sniper rifle scopes is, of course, the fact that you do get your obscured vision, but is that any different? Finally, however, the scope that I think is probably the best on our longbow synthesis here is the TAC SYS SLS-15. So, I do believe I should have this somewhere on here. The scopes I have are Ambush, which is rather frustrating. It's actually the first one on Praedus Timepiece, isn't it? There we go. So, this is a weird scope to do, but it's actually the most stable. You can actually see most notably, if you look in the top right, top left, and bottom right and bottom left corners, it distorts the outside images, but you do get a very stable scope. And that's the kind of drawback of this. This is personally one of the second best scopes, I think, for PvP players, because if you're using a sniper rifle correctly, you're not 100% of the time looking down the barrel, unless it's at a really big choke point, in which case the peripherals really don't matter. You should have your target in sight before you even scope in PvP, in my opinion, so that's really good. And for PvE, it's not a good scope, I'll admit, but you know, scopes in sniper rifles, the only thing that I'm really measuring them for, and the reason why it's so important, is because of the increases and decreases in stability and reload speed and range, which again, it will matter. Range matters a lot more in PvE, and stability and reload and all that other jazz, it matters a lot more in PvP. Now, perks on this weapon: snapshot, send it, and custom optics. So, there's a few winners in here. Longbow synthesis is naturally a little bit slow to aim down sight. It's nowhere near as snappy as something like, say, Praedith's Revenge, or let's say Patience and Time, where those things will aim in a heartbeat, it feels like. Very fast, really on point very quickly. So snapshot can be quite a winner, especially if you're taking this into PvP. PvE, however, I'd say not. Range and accuracy might be something you're looking for in PvE, but at this current point, I'm someone who's dissuaded from using range and accuracy on anything, even a sniper rifle. The only thing that I really see its advantage in is a shotgun, because with shotguns, range is everything. But on a sniper rifle like this, I don't know. I feel as though you're fine with what you have, and if you do equip a really long-range scope, you're probably going to be able to hit targets no matter what happens, and the range drop-off is just not going to be as much of a factor. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. But the last thing is something that's a bit of a dark horse: custom optic. I do wish, actually, that I had my, I should have taken my patience and time. But custom optic, what it will do is it lowers the optical zoom. And for those of you in PvP, it doesn't sound like a big advantage, but it's huge. And the reason is because, let's go ahead and say that I am up close and personal with one of these fallen, instead of back here, sitting around like a scrub. If that's the case, I can probably only see one of the fallen, or one of the enemies in PvP, as it will be the case. Having custom optic means that I have a way wider frame of view, and despite the fact that it's got extended magazine on it, I will actually use custom optic on Patience and Time over extended magazine and Field Scout. And that's really, it shows how much I value this perk. As a PvP player, having a wider scope is awesome, because you get so tunnel visioned while you're a sniper, and more often than not, you'll die because someone is 5 feet out of frame, and they've killed you by being, you know, literally just like over there. And I mean, think about how little difference that is when it comes to the grand picture of things. It means that you're much, much, much more aware when you're a sniper, and that is something that's invaluable. So out of all of these, custom optic, snapshot, best for PvP, PvE, maybe you go ahead and you take send it, but all of these are really PvP focused perks, I think, except for send it, which is really just sort of a bit of nothing. Anyway, something that will help you with the poor ammunition economy of this weapon is surplus. You can go ahead and use this a lot. I actually have a machine gun, Yolder's Hammer, which has surplus. And Yolder's Hammer is amazing! Because with surplus on Yolder's Hammer, you have a 25 round, or 30 or so round magazine to start with, as standard. With extended rounds, that increases it to like 50. So, if you're doing the concrete maths of it, with an extended magazine, you get about an extra 50% of the magazine from every single ammo pack. So let's say that the longbow synthesis is 5 rounds, and you have surplus. That means that instead of picking up 5 rounds with every single ammo pack, you're going to instead pick up 7 or 8. And given that that's like almost a complete refill of the weapon, that's like 60% of the ammunition, that's quite good. I wouldn't lie. It makes much more difference, however, on a heavy weapon. Something like one-way ticket, picking up something like 2 rockets as opposed to 1, given that I don't have heavy ammo on these boots, or rather I do. Wow. Radiant dance machines. Given that sometimes you don't always have heavy ammo on your boots, it means that it's really, really powerful on heavies. Specials, not so much. If they made it so that crucible ammunition was rarer for your special weapon, I think maybe it would be a different case and story. The other perk on here is Grenadier, and this I think is good in PvP again, but PvE, maybe it's also good. And the reason being is because if you're going to go ahead and you're just going to go ahead and kill a bunch of fallen, or anything like that, but you need to zone out a larger opponent or you just need extra damage, Grenadier is going to push it along quite significantly. And that's what I really, really love about the perk, because it's not something where it's just like energy drain, where it's a small, gradual increase over time. No, bam, you instantly get that energy back. So if you need the grenade then and there, as long as you can kill something, you've got it. PvP, that's amazing for zoning someone out. PvE, not so much. I'll admit, if it's something like a trip mine or a magnetic grenade or a fusion grenade, something along those lines where you can stick it, really, really powerful. But in other cases, it is one of those smaller marginal benefits. What are my personal favourite perks that I put on a sniper rifle? Well, this has got custom optic for PvP, but if I'm going to go for just a really all-purpose thing, then I would go ahead and say that you probably want to look for outlaw, which is that reload speed is increased when you get precision shots, because let's be honest, you should really only be getting precision shots with this. It's understandable if you'd have feeding frenzy instead, but I'm not sure if that perk is unique to Praetor's Revenge. And the other perk that I'd really recommend is unflinching, because in every single game mode, sometimes you're going to suffer horribly from flinch. It most certainly happens in PvP, and in PvE it's going to be just as bad, given that you do have enemies firing back at you, and when you've got something like a Hydra pounding down at you, you just need to get that one last shot off. I'd say that the perk is really valuable. And again, that's kind of my thing on snipers. It's not the weapon class that I know the best, I'll be 100% honest with you. And I use a lot of snipers in PvP if I can. And this is kind of something that I've really, really loved to do recently, but it's not my best weapon. And that's frustrating to me, to say the least, because some snipers, like the Longbow, have a really good base weapon, but it's not necessarily the case that every time you get one with great perks. And this is one of the ones with middling perks. The scope as well, it's something that I love for PvE, but PvP-wise, I would want to get my favorite scope of all of them, which is the lovely, tiny little ambush SLH-25. This thing is glorious to use in PvP, and it's just really fast, really snappy. Great stability, best stability in the game, and it's not weird and distorting your view at the sides. But anyway, enough of my ramblings on sniper rifles. I hope you enjoyed this, because I'm hoping to bring you guys a little bit more of this. I'm going to have a little bit of a content hiatus over the weekend, doing certain things over Valentine's Day, so don't expect content. I hope that I can keep up a reputation of giving you guys content on the weekdays and keeping it content-free on the weekend. And yeah, I'm going to try and do that, but prepare for a tiny, tiny hiatus of a few days. So yeah, my name has been, my name is Bife, and I will catch you guys around. Put our Darcy at Astra, I'll see you Starside. Goodbye, sir.
Let's take care of it. Fallen, about to drop on us. Thank you. Fallen, about to drop on us.
Done.